Welcome to Unboxing Wednesdays, episode 251 for comics coming out on August 19th, 2015. Yes, it's just me again today. Just me. So sad. So sad. That's right, Kevin is off gallivanting around, doing something. I'm not 100% sure what he's doing. He's probably in the bathroom and locked himself in. You know how Kevin does. Always pooping and peeing. I don't know. I don't know what he's doing. But yeah, it's just me. So let's go ahead and open up some boxes. Oh man, working up a sweat doing all this unboxing stuff. Really wish there was like a guy who could help me.
Hey Ricky, you forgot a box. Whoa. I got one right over here.
Is that Jason Liu?
That's me. And guess what?
What?
Look what came in the mail. New issues of Pitiful Human Lizard.
Whoa, let's see.
Issue number 5, written and drawn by yours truly. It is the last of the first story arc.
Yeah. Did these actually come in the mail, or did you just bring them?
I actually drove here and delivered them myself. Nice. Because that's the kind of gentleman I am to every local comic book shop. Yeah. This is the last issue that I've self-published before it carries on to Chapter House. I hope...
Ooh. Chapter House, they publish Captain Canuck right now.
Uh-huh. So I hope you guys ordered yours. Because that will be coming out late September.
Now, Jason, I need some help unboxing these toys. They're a little out of hand, so you
wanna... I was just gonna leave, but...
No,
I thought...
you have to work now. No free plugs!
Alright. Whoa, Ricky, look at all these toys we got here!
Too many!
It's so heavy! And I got all this Funko Pop figures, like Morocco Mole, Futurama's Fry... I'm kind of a muggle, so I might pronounce this name wrong. Albus Dumbledore from Harry Potter. Captain Cold, Agent Carter. Ron Weasley. Looks like a die-cast model of Batman's Batmobile. Wonder Woman! And Magneto. Plus, we got... Swamp Thing! This orange Green Lantern guy.
Well, Larfleeze, dude.
Larfleeze?
Larfleeze, one of the greatest characters coming out of the DC's Black as Night. Come on!
One of the greatest. Okay. Gundam! SDG Gundam Team SDR Mobile Suit. And we also got this adorable Adorps. Star-Lord. And this looks pretty fun. We got this set of Marvel 500 figurine sets. Oh, and we got some more toys from DC's Designer Series, all done by Jay Lee, like Wonder Woman, Catwoman, Superman, and the Batman. And we got so much adorable toys. Like these plushy Mo Peeps. No, how do you pronounce it? Mo Peeps. Mo Peeps.
Mopez, I don't know. All right, Jason had to head home because he's got to draw something about being a comic artist. I don't get it. Personally, I think he's a little off and he's going to go home to, So sorry. Where is Kevin to rein in the grossness? I don't know. But you know where he is? In my brain, because he told me to mention store.stadiumcomics.com. We have a whole bunch of pre-order packs going on. We have the Star Wars Force Awakens Shattered Empire collector set, where you can get a whole bunch of variants with that. We have the Marvel Hip Hop variants up on there, if you can get those. You know, I'm getting them, because I'm down with hip hop variants. That's just how I roll. I don't know about you. We also got the Amazing Spider-Man number 1 collector's pack that you can pick up. All that lovely stuff on store.stadiumcomics.com. And while I'm talking about stuff, let's talk about Comic Box here. Brilliant stuff. I just saw a review in Hebrew in Japan by this lovely couple. and it really warmed my heart. I didn't understand what they were saying, but that doesn't matter because I loved it. So thank you for reviewing that and being so beautiful. And if you'd like to also be beautiful, please subscribe to Comic Boxer, where you can get all these amazing comics to your door every month. First up, the collected editions, we have The Names by Vertigo. Heard a lot of great things about this series. Rogue, the complete collection. Who doesn't love Rogue? I know I do. This one's pretty interesting and pretty timely. We have the X-Men Alpha Age of Apocalypse. Not too sure what this collects, but you can be sure it's full of 90s goodness. One of my all-time favorite Marvel Now books, The Unbeatable Squirrel Girl. This book is chock full of amazingness and is hilarious and heartwarming and beautiful. You need to read this book. And finally, for the collected editions, we have the Miss Marvel hardcover. This thing is huge, super thick, and it's a hardcover. Miss Marvel, probably top five Marvel Now books. So definitely check this one out. All right, moving on to the smaller press books. We got a lot of books to talk about. First up, we got The Fiction, issue number 3. Buffy the Vampire Slayer, season 10, issue 18. Plants vs. Zombies, Bully for You, issue number 3. Giant Days, issue number 6. Birthright, issue number 10. Valiant's Rye, issue number 9. And a book I can't believe is still going on. Like, he's probably the longest running book that I thought should have not ran as long. Not because it's bad, but Invincible issue 122. Insanity. An independent superhero book running for that long. Crazy. Transformers Windblade number 6 has these two covers. And Ninja Turtles Animated Adventures number 1 has these two covers. One of my all-time favorite books. Honestly, the dialogue in this book is fantastic. Rat Queens issue 11. And you got Stepan Sajak on art. Oh, so good. Though I don't think he's doing it anymore, because he got sick. He's just doing the covers, it seems. The smash hit Invader Zim number 2. These pretty wicked covers here. The regular edition of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles number 49. And it also has this variant here, super cool. I know I've said this before, but if you're not watching Rick and Morty, you are probably the craziest person I've ever met. We have Rick and Morty issue number 5. This show is both hilarious, heartbreaking, making you think worthy. It's everything. It's so good, you should be watching it. Now, everyone knows I'm a big fan of poop jokes. That's right. It's not very hard to make me laugh. You just fart, poop. And Garbage Pail Kids knows exactly what I'm about. We got this one shot featuring Methane Max. Not only was Mad Max great, but I imagine Methane Max is even better. Hellbreak, issue number 6. Fiona and Cake, Card Wars, issue number 2. Have you guys been reading the new rebooted Archie? It's been making tons of waves. And we got the second issue right here featuring Veronica looking for some lingerie. I wonder what's going on tonight. Tonight! No? Aqua Teen Hunger Force, anybody? My Little Pony, issue 33. Book of Death, issue number 2. And it also comes with this pretty sweet variant cover. Remember how Valiant had that super limited series, The Legends of the Geomancer? Well, the second issue's out today, so that is it. So nice. And finally, for the small press books, we have Welcome Back, issue number 1 from Boom Studios. This one's been pushed pretty heavily by Boom, and I'm pretty sure it's going to be a hit, so definitely check it out. We got this variant for it, and this variant here. Alright guys, time to move on to DC, and we're going to start off with Sensational Comics featuring Wonder Woman, issue 13. Green Lantern, The Lost Army, issue number 3. Robin, Son of Batman. You've been reading this? I'm hearing really great stuff about it. Speaking of Invincible and books I can't believe lasted that long, Injustice, Gods Among Us, year 4, issue number 8. How can they continue the Injustice series? What's going on in this book? Please, in the comments, let me know what's going on. The game was pretty finite. I can't imagine how they expanded on it. Someone who's severely lacking in bombshell covers, The Martian Manhunter, issue number 3. Look at this cover. His head is like exploding. This is crazy. Love it. Love it. Speaking of Martian Manhunter, he was featured in All-Star Section 8, issue number 3. Are you guys reading All-Star Section 8? It's literally the funniest book I've ever read. I'm dying every time I read it. And the Martian Manhunter's in it, and he's so into being on the team until he meets Bueno Excelente. You know what's up with him. Oh, so good. I love this series. Bizarro issue number 3. Gotta love Bizarro. Dr. Fate issue number 3. Secret 6 issue number 5. And this also features our first bombshell cover of the week. I'm pretty sure this one's gonna sell out. This one featuring Harley Quinn. Anything with Harley Quinn on it, you know is gonna sell like crazy. So if you want this, better go to your store real quick. Batman Arkham Knight issue number 7. Have you played the game? Really awesome game. I loved it. I thought the ending was fantastic. So if you haven't played it, definitely check it out. Superman Wonder Woman issue number 20. Looks like Superman is still super emo. And the bombshell variant for Superman and Wonder Woman. We have Harley Quinn Power Girl issue number 3. Check out the dude with the sweet pierced nipples. Real deviant there. That's what I like to see. Tonight! Again, Aqua Teen Hunger Force, guys. Watch it. Justice League Gods and Monsters issue number 2. Black Canary issue number 3. Wonder Woman issue number 43. Sad to see David Finch isn't drawing this one anymore. But, you know, he's probably doing bigger things. And it also has this bombshell variant featuring an Amazon Wonder Woman, literally an Amazonian. Fantastic. And finally, we have Justice League issue 43. This one looks like an intense issue. And it also features this bombshell variant cover featuring three of the women on it. Fantastic. All right, moving on to Marvel. Marvel Comics, that's right. We're gonna start off with the Runaways issue number 3. A book I'm really digging, Inferno issue number 4. It's got Forge in it. Is that like a, it's like Forge Mr. Sinister at the same time. Or it could just be Mr. Sinister, I don't know. Maybe Forge is in there. Why is it gotta be a fusion? Doesn't, I don't know. A book I thought was gonna be poo until I picked it up and I was blown away by how amazing it is. Secret Wars Journal issue number 4. Definitely check it out if you're into the side stories of Battle World. Extinction Agenda issue number 3. Last of Days, we got Loki, Agent of Asgard number 17. One of the strangest Marvel Secret Wars tie-ins we have is 1872 issue number 2. So it's like the Marvel Universe but in 1872. Weird, but also awesome. Guardians of Nowhere issue number 3. Empire of the Dead issue number 4. Guardians Team Up issue number 10. Deadpool stole a bike from a young Zelda. Poor girl. Silk issue number 6. Secret Wars Secret Love. Ooh, I really like this pulp novel cover. Really interesting. Pretty sure that book is all about love happening in Battle World. So like, you know, people shacking up. I don't know if there's any shacking up. I haven't read it. Kids don't even say shacking up anymore. They probably say f***ing and f***ing and f***ing in it, so who knows, right? Spider-Verse issue number 4. This one, a lot of people have been picking up. Looks like a good one. Spider-Verse also comes with this variant here. Have you been reading Howard the Duck? It's been pretty great, but I don't know if it'll be as good as Howard the Human. Look at these covers. Fantastic stuff. I love them all. Whoever comes up with this stuff over at Marvel needs a raise because it's fantastic, and I love it. We got Spider-Man Renew Your Vows issue number 4. This issue is going to be huge. And we got this awesome variant cover, as well as this wicked variant cover. Canon The Last Padawan issue number 5. We have Star Wars issue number 8. Also has this variant and this awesome Tusken Raider action figure variant. And finally for Marvel, we have House of M, the heavily delayed, long-awaited title, House of M, set in the wildly tumultuous time where mutants were on the run and a lot of them were disappearing. We got the blank cover for that one. This super awesome variant. Look at that Sentinel, super cool. This mega triumphant variant and this lovely painted variant. All right guys, so last week we're giving out a copy of the DC Comics Bombshell issue number 1, which BT dubs is probably one of the coolest comics I've read recently. It's full of interesting characters and the art is beautiful. Like, Beautiful. Beautiful. So whoever wins this is a lucky person because it's so good. We had a lot of awesome answers. DJ I Love You 44 could be his name. That's what I made it to be. Says, the biggest bombshell in comics is The Dark Knight Returns. Without it, we would not have a Batman that we know. That is true. Frank Miller redefined the crazy that is Batman. And himself. Guy's nuts. Mr. Koo said, the biggest bombshell in the comics world was when I was reading Walking Dead 100. I nearly cried. I read those few pages of gore like 6 times. I couldn't believe it. To this day, I don't think a comic has hurt me like that. After reading it, I didn't read another Walking Dead issue for like 4 months. I was heartbroken. Yeah, that issue was pretty intense. That was the only issue of Walking Dead I've ever read, like, truth be told. And even I was like, So, I feel you, dude. James Lee said, biggest bombshell is X-23 getting her own series and picking up the mantle, which is going to be awesome. I agree. The all-new, all-different X-Men has X-23 as Wolverine. And not only does she look great in that costume, but X-23 is super cool. I really like the acrobatics and the claws on the feet. Tony Iflow Sandals said, biggest bombshell for me was the Airboy series. Just absolutely awesome art and story. I agree, dude. Airboy is probably one of the coolest comics out there right now. It really kind of brings meta to a whole new level. It's like got, you know, Airboy and the writer and the creator, and you're like, these guys are the worst people in the world, and they're like, we know. It's great. I love it. It's so good. If you have an opportunity, read it. It's only 4 issues, so you have no excuse. Ken Ives said, my favorite bombshell in comics was the destruction of the Marvel Universe. I'm really enjoying the world created by God Doom. Finally, a god that you can believe in. I agree, man. Everything about Secret Wars has been fantastic. I mean, not only do you have Esad Ribic killing it on art, like literally destroying it, but like with his fists, with like pencils, he's just killing Secret Wars. And it's so good. Jonathan Hickman, usually I don't find his writing to be very approachable. It's sometimes kind of weird. And Secret Wars is weird, but it's still really cohesive, really readable. I'm in love with Secret Wars, honestly. After Axis, I was like, yo, Marvel can't do events. Axis is garbage. But no, they brought the thunder with Secret Wars. They're like, let me give it to you all night long with Secret Wars. Then I gladly accepted. But the winner goes to Mega Man Chief Fan, who said, the biggest bombshell is either the death of Gwen Stacy or Watchmen. Think about it. Gwen Stacy's death helped open the door to the comic book world in terms of dark content and mainstream attention. But the first comic to fully use the potential opened by Gwen Stacy's death is Watchmen. It was dark, gritty, yet subtle and entertaining. People will say The Dark Knight Returns did this better, but in my opinion, Watchmen steps all over that story, even though Dark Knight Returns is a really good story. Though I have my own opinions on The Watchmen, I can't disagree that it is a great read. It's fantastic, it's nuanced, like a fine wine. But The Watchmen and the death of Gwen Stacy certainly did bring a whole new aspect to mainstream comics. Because, of course, underground comics, which is nuts. Like, crazy stuff was happening there. But in terms of mainstream comics, I'd say those two are pretty influential. So congratulations, Mega Man Chief Fan. You win a copy of the DC Comics Bombshells issue number 1. This week, what we're giving out is House of M issue number 1. And in it, Scarlet Witch wishes all the mutants to be gone, creating a whole chaos of worlds. And what I'd like to know from you in the comments is, if you could wish one thing away, what would it be? I think me personally, I would wish away mosquitoes. Those things are pieces of crap, and I'm pretty sure if they disappeared, nothing would be affected. Literally nothing. Life would go on as normal. They don't even provide enough nutrients for things that eat the mosquitoes. All they do is annoy me and suck my blood. Screw those guys. Scarlet Witch, wish them away. So leave in the comments what you would like to wish away, and the best answer will win a copy of House of M number 1. All right, everybody, that is the end of today's episode, episode 251. Fantastic stuff. Did you guys have fun? Thanks to our guest, Jason. for showing us some toys and showing us Pitiful Human Lizard number 5. That book looks wicked. Sorry last week for cutting out DC. I don't know what happened there. It just didn't get in the cut. I was looking at it and I was like, you know, I'm not feeling it. Cut it out. Director's cut. Cut it out. Yeah, I have no idea how that happened. But it happened. We got the little teaser clip up of just DC Comics stuff. So that was good. At least we could help you guys out that way. Be sure to check out store.stadiumcomics.com for all your pre-order needs. Comic Boxer, of course. Louis Podcast for all your recapping needs. And, you know, next week, I'm back here again by myself. That's right, Kevin will probably still be locked in that bathroom. Or gallivanting around town. Who knows what he's doing. So I'll see you guys next week where it'll be just me. So please strap in yourselves for a double Ricky week. Oh yeah. See you guys next week.